Hello, you gorgeous, lovely people. This is Chris from Macombu, and I'm here with the Fitbit Ionic smartwatch to give a quick tour. I say quick, it's probably going to be quite an extensive tour of all of the different features, the OS, all of the software stuff, and also show how it pairs up with the Fitbit app that's available on either iOS or Android. If you want to know more about the actual hardware, go check out our full unboxing. It's quite an extensive 8-minute effort where I go into all of the various details of the watch itself. But let's have a bit of a tour of the OS, which is of Fitbit's own design. As you can see, it's a full touchscreen affair, so you can flick around to get to the various functionality, and there is a lot of features packed in there as well. Definitely a rival to the likes of the Apple Watch, especially when it comes to the fitness stuff, which you'd expect for the £300 asking price, really. So first of all, it does automatically pop up the clock face with a quick twist of the wrist, or you can also have it so you have to manually do it with one of the buttons. So a press of any of these little side buttons will also pop the watch into life. You get a variety of clock faces, so this is the default one right here. You give it a quick tap and it tells you basically all your sort of main stats at the moment. So my heart rate is incredibly high. There you go, I'm clearly very excited doing this video. How many calories you've burned so far today and how many steps you've taken. I've literally gone to the bathroom and that's about it, hence mine is pretty poor so far. Don't judge me on that. But of course you can change that quite happily. So what you do is you download the Fitbit app via either the App Store or Google Play, and then you connect it quickly and simply to your new smart device. All you have to do is click tap set up a new device and it immediately detects it, pairs it up. It's nice and easy, straightforward, and also nice and secure as well. And then that basically gives you a dashboard which allows you to configure quite a lot of the aspects of the Fitbit Ionic. So for instance, you'll immediately notice clock faces, hooray. Dive into that, it shows you what you've got at the moment, gives you a little bit of a description and stuff as well. You just tap pick a new clock. You then get a small selection. There's about, I think about like sort of 15 or so in all. And quite a lot of them are kind of similar, often the same sort of design. A lot of them are digital. You can of course get all of your stats right there on the front. If you want a more basic streamlined affair, you can also get that. For instance, this one here just has your number of steps. And of course you can also go full analog as well, if you so desire. Some of the analog ones don't work too great, unfortunately. For instance, I tried this one, the sleek one originally. And try that, and basically all you need to do is tap them and it downloads them and then loads them up onto the watch, so eventually it should beam it over. This is the other thing I've noticed while using the Fitbit, is that sometimes transferring data between the phone and the watch can take a little while. For instance, we're going to touch on the music stuff later, that takes a good long while. And just simple things like this, I mean, this is a 186 kilobyte file, it's absolutely tiny, and yet still seems to take its sweet time getting onto the watch. You can be hanging around a good minute or so. So this is definitely for more patient people. Whereas of course the Apple Watch, it generally takes a couple of seconds and it's done. Okay, here we go. The watch is kicking into life. We're now getting that face transferred over. And there we have it. So now we have our new analog watch. But of course it's got this stretched aspect ratio because it's not a fully square screen, unlike the Apple Watches, for instance. I will probably bang on about the Apple Watch quite a lot in this video. So as you can see, it's kind of awkward and sometimes can make it a little bit difficult to actually work out what the time is, which is a bit of a shame. Some of the other analog clock faces do have a more rounded affair, such as this nautical one. But you also lose the top and the bottom edges, unfortunately, which is kind of a bit weird. But never mind, you know, at least you've got a variety to choose from here. You've got obviously a nice cinemagraph one with a nice bit of picture background action. And some jazzy affairs. Look at this little disco number here. Very nice indeed. Personally, I actually quite prefer the standard default one, so I'm just happy to stick with that, to be honest. In the meantime, let's have a bit of a flick around, because thankfully when you are transferring files, you can just get on with other stuff. So if you flick right across the screen, it brings up a couple of quick options, screen wake, either auto or manual. So as I said before, you can turn on the screen with a quick flick of your wrist, otherwise you can have it just buttons only. And notifications as well, you do get full notification support, which is absolutely lovely, and it works instantly as well. As soon as a notification pops onto your phone, it will pop up onto the Fitbit. It happens like this, so just flick up and you can see all of your waiting notifications. Otherwise, they do just pop up on the screen as they come in as well, which is good. As I say, absolutely instant. And the way this is all controlled is again via the app. Quite a lot of the controls are done via the app. If you head down to the notification section, you'll see that calls, texts, and calendar events are selected by default. And also, as soon as an app appears on your smartphone, you can then have it coming through to your watch as well. So third-party stuff from the likes of iCatcher, Gmail, Spotify Music and stuff, that can actually be streamed to your watch as well. So the notification support is actually really solid on the Ionic. Definitely happy with that. If you flick down the screen instead, you will load up the media player, which is really, really handy if you have some Bluetooth headphones. You want to go out for a bit of a run, bit of a gym session, but you don't want to take your massive iPhone out or whatever other mobile device you happen to be using. You can just pair up with some headphones and away you go. So, for instance, I have just the Jam Ultras here. I've already paired these up to the watch. So once you pop them out, they should immediately pair, and then we'll be able to listen to some music. Right, so it's now paired with the Jam Ultras, nice and quick and straightforward. Now all we have to do is head to the music app, which is here in the app section. Just a quick swipe left to access that. And there you go, this is the single playlist that I've set up at the moment. This is the one bugbear, unfortunately, with listening to music on the Fitbit Ionic. You have to set up an iTunes playlist in order to listen to your tunes. You can't just drag and drop certain music tracks across. So what you'll need to do is you'll need to download the Fitbit app onto your PC or your MacBook. There's full instructions on how to do that right here in the how to use section of the app and also on Fitbit's website. And once you've done that, you can basically set up an iTunes playlist, and then you can immediately copy that across to the watch wirelessly over Wi-Fi. Make sure obviously your computer and the Fitbit are connected to the same Wi-Fi network. And then once that's done, you've finally got some music on here, and you just give this quick tap, and then give that a tap. And for some reason it's saying no output device, even though it's connected to those Jam Ultras, so that's a bit worrying. Jam Ultra. Okay, so it looks like you actually have to tap that in that section as well, even though they've already paired. Okay, right, now we know that. So let's go back again, and here we go. And we should be able to hit play. There we go, and our music is playing. Brilliant, okay. And of course the controls are nice and easy as well. You can pause and play with a quick tap of this side button. You can skip a track with a tap of that side button. And if you just tap these three dots in the top left corner here, you'll bring up even more controls as well. So you can skip back, you can shuffle your tracks, and of course you can do volume up and volume down. So it's pretty handy if you want to, as I say, take a run and you want to listen to some tunes on the go without having to take your smartphone with you. And how much storage space does it have? I believe it was around 16 gigabytes of storage space, 8 to 16. So enough for 300 songs, they reckoned. So certainly you can get a decent amount of music on there, or some podcasts or whatever else you want to listen to. So as I said before, quick swipe left and you access your apps menu. And there's a small selection of apps to begin with, but we're expecting that to expand quite rapidly. So as you can see, obviously you've got today, which tells you all about how you've done today with your various stats. You can also access that at any time if you head back to the main menu just by tapping this top button here, and that immediately brings up all of your stats. There we go, lovely stuff. Of course, for altitude, meter and all that kind of stuff built in there as well. Tap of this down button and you can access all of the quick exercise features. We'll cover that in a second. And what other apps do we have here? So we've got the fitness coach, of course, which we saw before. That just sort of teaches you how to perform various quite intensive exercise sessions, sort of guides you through those and allows you to get nice and fit without even leaving the comfort of your own home, which is quite handy. Exercise, of course, there we go, we've already seen that. Relax, this basically just allows you to control your breathing and just have a bit of a chill out session when you're feeling maybe a little bit stressed. So just give that a tap and it guides you through, just like on the Apple Watch, breathing in, breathing out, and just chilling out. And it gives you your heartbeat stats and all the rest of it at the end of that. You've also got, of course, alarms. You can rock this at night and it's it will monitor your sleep session, see how good of a sleep you've had. And of course, you can set up an alarm to gently rouse you the next morning. And of course, timers as well, which is handy, again, if you're measuring the length of a fitness session or just boiling an egg or something, always good to have. Now, wallet is one of the more interesting features. You've actually got this new feature called Fitbit Pay, which allows you at any time to basically just hold that back button and then place it on a an electronic payment device. And you can immediately make a payment, just like you can with the likes of Apple Pay, Google Pay, stuff like that. So that's definitely a very interesting new feature. And there you go. And of course, it's fully PIN protected, so you have to enter your PIN in order to make the payment, so no one can just nick your watch and then go around on a spending spree, which is always handy. So that's definitely a very cool new feature as well. We'll be testing that out in full once it goes live. I believe it's the 17th that kicks in. Another swipe, are you going to the weather app, which for some reason never comes back with any weather for me. Oh no, there we go, finally. Right, brilliant. The first 24 hours, it refused to give me any weather, despite the fact that I'd set it up, again, via the app section here. So this basically shows you all of your apps and allows you to sort of go in and tweak the settings of a couple of the apps. So for instance, you can do that with the weather app. And at the moment, as I say, this will probably be where you download more apps in the future. I've got all of them downloaded right now for testing. And aside from the weather, which looks pretty dull and dreary today, of course, got Strava as well, if you were a Strava member, to record all your training sessions and all the rest of it. And then finally, the settings. And here you can obviously change the brightness. It's a full 1000 nit brightness on the maximum level, so you'll have absolutely no trouble seeing the sea, even with lots of strong light bouncing off the screen. You'll have absolutely no problems with clarity, that's for sure. And change the vibration intensity. Heart rate monitoring can be changed, so it doesn't measure every 5 seconds your interval. Instead, it can just be completely turned off to help save the battery life. Notification support, you can have a tweak around with that as well. So for instance, during exercise and sleep, no notifications please, I'm busy. That's all good. Bluetooth wise, and you can connect to your headphones using that, so that's nice and easy. So those are the apps on offer at the moment. As you can see, quite a streamlined affair, not quite as many as you get on the likes of the Apple Watch, but we are expecting that to expand in the near future. Quite a lot of other third-party app creators coming on board. Hopefully we'll get to see some like funky games and stuff like that as well to keep you amused on the go, and of course more support for various fitness features, and hopefully more media players as well. At the moment, you can only really get involved with, as I say, your own personal tunes, using a bit of iTunes, the playlist and everything as well, but you can also stream Pandora as well. If you're a Pandora Plus member, I believe, whatever the premium subscription is, you can stream a bit of that to your Fitbit as well. And of course, from the Fitbit app, you can see exactly what you've been up to. So for instance, I somehow managed to get 6 hours and 58 minutes of sleep, although I apparently spent 47 minutes of that awake, which would be when my daughter burst in unexpectedly at 3 a.m. Check out your current heart rate and your rested heart rate. Get exact indication of it. You could fill in all your dietary stuff there as well if you want an exact count of how many calories you've consumed and all that kind of thing. And of course, it gives you all your main stats there. And of course, there's various challenges you can take on with some friends as well. So if you dive into the friends menu, you can get connected to other people in there. And it just gives you a little sort of morale boost, I guess, or gives you a reason to say, oh, that git's done a 10-mile run right today and I've just sat on my ass watching a bit of, I don't know, Narcos or whatever. So it allows you to dive in there, get some challenges on the go and really get yourself active, which is definitely a good thing. And of course, here's the FitStart effort again as well. It gives you some video indication of the kind of little challenges you can set yourself, the little fitness sessions you can do. As I say, just right there in your home. You don't even need equipment with a lot of these, which is really, really good. There's the friend section where you hook up with people. You can hook up via Facebook, via your email contacts, whatever. And then, of course, all of your various devices. I have quite a few, as you see. I've tested a few of these Fitbit jobbies by now. So, yeah, it's definitely, in terms of the fitness features, pretty extensive. The last thing I'm going to show you is just the exercise session. It can actually automatically detect when you're running, for instance, so it can automatically track that. Otherwise, you could dive into here nice and quick, just flick through to whatever session you're doing. So, for instance, because it's 15 meters water resistant, you can track your swimming sessions, the lengths, the calories burned, all the rest of it. Weights, interval timers, and again, you can remove any of these that you're not going to do. Any that you're interested in, just give it a tap, hit play, and away you go. You can get started in with that FitStar, and it tells you exactly how your heart rate's doing, how many calories you've burned so far, and all the rest. So definitely, if you're interested in your fitness, there's plenty on here, plenty of good third-party support as well to keep you going. As you can see, you can just stop that, and yep, finished our session end. Nice work, 1 calorie burned, good job you. So yeah, so definitely for the fitness fanatic, there are lots of good things on here. At least it's got that onboard music playing. The notification support is great. And definitely with some proper app support from third-party vendors and all the rest of it, it could be a very, very solid device indeed. So stay tuned for our full in-depth review of the Fitbit Ionic coming very shortly indeed. And thanks for watching, everyone. Cheers, bye.